Hello students, hearty congratulations for your creditable success at SSC examination. Now you have entered higher education in college. So myself, Jagjap SB, will teach you subject biology. Now while studying in 10th standard, you have studied science in two parts. So from this year, that is 11th science, you are going to learn the science in different subjects, physics, chemistry, then biology. So I am going to teach and explain you subject biology. Now due to certain reasons like our COVID-19 situation, our regular lectures in college are not taking place. So we have started online lectures for you. So due to this COVID-19, some syllabus from your textbook has been reduced. So this reduced syllabus, we will discuss it regarding our regular topics or chapters. So today we are going to start our first chapter, that is living world. Now the name itself indicates that we all live on planet Earth, and on planet Earth there are two main factors. The first one is abiotic factor and second one is biotic factor. So abiotic factors are those which are non-living. Non-living means they do not show different life processes. For example, water, air, soil, mountains. These are all non-living things and they come under one term, that is abiotic factors. Then living organisms which show different life processes come under biotic factors. So our earth consists of two main factors, that is abiotic factor and biotic. Now living organisms show some basic principles of life. So first basic principle of life or living organism is metabolism. So metabolism is a process which occurs in only living organisms. These are the different biological processes which occur in living organisms. Then metabolism consists of two types. The first one is catabolism and second one is anabolism. Now catabolism means the biomolecules or conversion of biomolecules into simpler form, or it is breaking of biomolecules. For example, respiration. Now you know that plants as well as animals carry the process of respiration. Now respiration is an energy releasing process. During this process, complex food material is converted into simple form, or it is broken down into simple form, and energy is released. This energy is used by living organisms for all their activities. Now the second type is anabolism. Example of it is photosynthesis. Now anabolism means it is an assimilatory process. That means different substances are built up by using biomolecules. So in photosynthesis, we see that green plants produce their own food material with the help of sunlight, carbon dioxide, then water. And they produce food material or carbohydrates. So this assimilatory process is called as anabolism. Then second basic principle is growth and development of living organisms. So living organisms show growth and development up to a specific period. Now there is difference in growth between organisms. So growth occurs due to cell division in living organisms. So growth and development of living organism is one of the important life process. Now the third basic principle of life is aging process. So cells, tissues and organs after certain period of time lose their working capacity, and due to which the aging occurs in living organisms. So you know that cells get organized into tissues, then tissues get organized into different organs and organ systems, and they form a complete organism. So when all these cells, tissues and organs start to lose their working capacity, the organism start to age, then the next basic principle of life is reproduction. Reproduction is a process in which organisms give rise to a similar kind of organism. Now reproduction is of two types: asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. In asexual reproduction, there is no fusion of male gamete with female gamete, and the process of fertilization does not occur. While in sexual reproduction, there is union of male gamete with female gamete, then fertilization occurs, and the process is called as sexual reproduction. So reproduction is one of the important basic principle in the life of living organisms. Then response. Living organisms respond to different types of chemical, thermal or biological changes which occur in the surrounding. For example, there are different chemical changes. For example, plants, due to pollution, there are different chemical changes in the soil, then atmosphere get polluted. So these all chemicals affect the growth and development of plants. Then there are temperature fluctuations. Temperature may be very high or it may be sometimes very low. So these thermal changes also affect the response of living organisms. Then different kinds of biological changes which occur in the environment affect the response of living organisms. Then the last basic principle of life is death. So when an organism loses its metabolic capacity, or the metabolism of an organism is lost. Metabolism means different biological processes like catabolism, anabolism occur in living organisms. So when these processes stop or the metabolism is lost, the living organisms die.